Story 38. Patrick Magee, Ireland. Lumen Electronics, Director, Electronic Engineering. That's amazing. I'd love a culture like that. But it wouldn't work here. Not in Ireland. We're too guarded, reserved, and cynical. I'd get some strange looks if I announced improvement time in morning meetings. Besides, we do custom designs, not mass manufacturing, so a lot of that doesn't apply. Not to mention, this is electronic engineering. Being disorganized is the standard. I'll get the tools organized, but the rest of that lean stuff won't work here. Still, this Paul Akers guy had won me over with his videos, so I bought some Kaizen foam and organized a tool chest. It's kick-ass. So began my interest in following Paul's videos, the books, the podcast, the factory tours. It's all amazing and inspirational. This guy's awesome. But lean won't work here. I know I've got to get organized. I'm turning a one-man consultancy into a proper product development business with just myself and one technician. It's fine. I'll just work hard and it will all be good. Add another technician, an admin assistant, some subcontractors. That should put an end to the 70-hour weeks, right? I've always been a hands-on engineer. I love getting the overalls on and actually putting our products on machines. That's my ikigai. Tonight was not ikigai. It was 11 p.m. on a cold January night, and I'm on my own on the factory floor. The job is frustrating. I have three others that are staying late. Did I order those parts? I'm supposed to chase that invoice. My eyes are stinging. That's the wrong drawing. The laptops are dead, and I've got to be up again at 6 a.m. to do this all again. Why are you even here? No one else does this, and this isn't a one-off effort. This is every damn day. The motion-activated lights were going out all around me. In silence, I let them go out one by one. This really isn't working here. Epiphanies are rare, but I had one within 5 minutes of my first visit to 2 Second Lean Maniacs at Seating Matters. Stand here and watch this process, Declan instructed. Okay, he's cutting leather, seems well-organized, very tidy. Neat, what's next? My internal monologue quickly interrupted by his declaration. Waste, waste, value, waste, value, 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 waste, value, value, waste. In the movie The Matrix, there's a scene where the hero's vision changes so that he can see everything as it really is. I stared at that cutting table, absorbing what I had just learned. Declan summed it up neatly. The only time he's adding value is when the knife goes through the leather. Everything else is waste. The next morning, I eagerly announced the beginning of our lean journey. I probably mumbled my way through the leather story, something about eight wastes and a guy named Paul Akers. Has anyone any improvement ideas? There were some strange looks. That went terrible. I thought, I can't wait to do it tomorrow. I did, and the next day, and the next. It was far from overnight, but soon, the team engaged in 3S-ing and started making 2 Second Lean improvements. When we started, over 80% of our facility was consumed by stock and junk, just three actual workstations for value adding. 18 months later, and my team have transformed the place. Inventory down by 80%. 14 workstations available for projects. And administration and engineering sharing an open plan office. The best part is how little I had to do with it. In fact, I was consistently putting off the, quote, big switch moving production to the main area for fear it would interrupt service. The team took advantage of one of my trips away and got it done. My team got it. While I'm aware just how far we have to go, I know where we are going. I take great encouragement when customers and visitors comment on the changes we have made here. Quote, the Gemba is the salesman. The owner of Hox Electronics Japan informed us, quote, when customers come to see us, they only buy from us. Just one of the countless amazing lessons learned on the Japan study mission. The greatest impact Lean has had for me isn't our ever-improving Gemba. It's an amazing network of people in the Lean community that have become acquaintances and friends. Just 18 months ago, I had no one I could call a mentor. Now I have access to literally dozens of the world's best business and engineering minds. All I had to do was ask. I couldn't have been more wrong when I told myself the 2 Second Lean culture wouldn't work here. It works everywhere people want to make a contribution. I'm very fortunate to have been blessed with this amazing opportunity, and I'm determined to make the next 18 months an even more epic transformation.